Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about bladder diverticular imaging. Bladder diverticular is a herniation of the urinary bladder mucosa through bladder detrusor muscle. Primary poor muscle back being near urethrovesical junction. Periurethral, most common congenital diverticulum, 90%. Secondary, acquired. Chronic polyelevated bladder pressure, weak bladder wall in connective tissue disorder, iatrogenic traumatic cause. Presentation most are found incidentally. Other cases, urinary tract infection, hematuria, voiding dysfunction, pain, urinary tract infection due to stagnant urine or NOVR. Hematuria may be due to associated calculus. Voiding dysfunction manifests with urinary incontinence or retention, pain, especially if associated with obstruction. Demographic age, any, primary most frequently present in childhood. Fact, primary and secondary are much more common in male. Epidemiology, estimated 1.7% incident of primary diverticular. Of all bladder diverticular, 10% are primary and 90% are acquired. Single diverticulum in 70%, multiple in 30%. 60% with diverticulum have underlying urinary abnormality. Upper tract anomaly in 16 to 30% of cases. Top difference analysis. Averting urethral cell, urethral stem, ovarian, paraovarian cyst, gastrointestinal duplication cyst. Best diagnostic clue. Round cystic focus directly adjacent to bladder. Change size with bladder filling and or voiding. Anechoic or ultrasound plus minus change of urine into bladder. Filled with contrast on voiding cystourethrogram. Diverticula with narrow necks may be small or absent during bladder fill and only seen with voiding. Contrast may remain after bladder emptying. Vesicourethral reflux in 50%. Large diverticulum incorporated and distort urethrovesical junction, leading to vesicourethral reflux. Without history of neurogenic bladder or bladder outlet obstruction, multiple diverticular should suggest syndrome. William, Mann, L. Danlos, Kutisalaksa. This is color Doppler ultrasound of a urinary bladder. So not only a jet of urine draining from a diverticulum, but also a jet of urine emanating from the adjacent urethral orifice in this patient with periurethral diverticulum. Fluoroscopic voiding cystourethrogram, VCUJ, was performed tension torsion to the neck of a moderate to large bladder diverticulum. A projection demonstrating the neck should be acquired when a diverticulum is encountered. We see Eugene in a 3.5 years old with Menk disease, somatic power moderate to light diverticulite about the bladder, characteristic of these connecting tissues disease. Other CT with this apparent include Williams syndrome, cutis laser, and Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Contrast enhanced CT performed for pain and fever in a teenage boy saw a cystic mass in the retrovesical space with connection to the urinary bladder, suggesting a bladder diverticulum. Note a markedly second urinary bladder wall with mucosal hyper enhancement, suggesting inflammation from a urinary tract infection. 3D SSFPMR demonstrates bilateral periurethral diverticular ligature on the left side. Treatment, conservative observation, plus minus chemo prophylaxis. Small asymptomatic diverticular without complication, persistent symptom despite conservative management indicate needed for operative intervention, surgery, resection of diverticulum, plus minus urethral reimplant. Recurrent infection or persistent voiding dysfunction are most common reason. Periurethral valve diverticula are most likely to require operation. Proximity of neck to urethral orifice is important in deciding whether or not to place perioperative stents. Thank you.